Hello, my friend. Welcome to TubeU China. Recently, there has been a significant update to the Stable Diffusion Web UI Automatic 1111 in Torch 2. This update has greatly enhanced stability and increased speed by approximately 40% when utilizing XFormers. Additionally, I have discovered that employing different sampling methods can lead to varying performance outcomes. To provide you with accurate results, I will conduct a label test and share the findings. This will allow you to save time and focus on your initial exploring work. Let's begin. Here are the test conditions. My computer hardware is not advanced, particularly my relatively old graphic card. I'm using the DreamShape motor, which is one of my favorite for generating highly realistic images. For the parameters, I'm using a simple positive prompt featuring a girl with pink hair, along with easy negative as the negative prompt. The resolution is set at 512x512, with high resolution fixed upscale by 2 over 20 steps. The denoising strength is set to 0.7. With these parameters, a good sampling method can yield excellent image results. To ensure accuracy, I run each image separately 3 times to eliminate uncertainty. Let's now examine the image generation time and the quality of the generated images. There are currently a total of 22 available sampling methods for image generation. These methods can be employed with a standard resolution of 512x512, which can then be scaled up by 2 to 1024x1024. Almost all of the images produced are of high quality. Interestingly, even when using the same parameters and seed, the output image can vary, with some displaying remarkably certain creative qualities. For instance, DPM Fast produces images with a completely different style and remarkably speed, which might presently surprise you. The other methods such as ULA, LMS, and most others exhibit similarity in output, while the faster sampling methods like ULA, LMS, DPM++ 2M, LMS Keras, DPM++ 2M Keras, DDIM, and UniPC are preferred. Particularly, DPM++ 2M Keras, DDIM, and UniPC. Alternatively, ultra samplers provide a distinct choice, offering images that differ significantly from the aforementioned methods. ULA A, in particular, is quite popular as it generates high-quality images at a rapid pace. The SDE sampling method results in slightly different images, often incorporating backgrounds that enhance details and contribute to a more realistic appearance. DPM++ 2M SDE Keras is another notable method that produces excellent images with remarkable speed. DPM Fast and PLMS offer additional options for generating stunning images and are worth trying out. It is worth noting that DPM Adaptive is known to produce high-quality images but has the slowest speed among the available methods. From the image generation speed analysis, we can observe that the methods can be divided into 3 groups based on speed. The fast speed group consists of only half time compared to the slow speed group. I recommend trying the faster methods first to identify your favorite images. Comparing the image generation speeds with the previous version, Torch 1.13, CUDA 11.7, and XFormers 0.0.16, the different speed groups remain the same. However, the new version offers a broader range of sampling methods and an approximately 40% increase in image generation speed. With the new Torch 2.0.1, CUDA 11.8, and exformers 0.0.17. You can expect a smoother and faster image generation experience. Let's go ahead and examine another parameter-rich item, the upscale method. By using the same parameters as before, except for the upscaler, I employed the sampling method with DPM plus 2M keras. I generated the image 3 separate times and averaged the results to reduce uncertainty. All of the latent methods exhibit considerable similarity, and they also generate images with impressive speed. For my regular samplers, I will employ the latent method. Additionally, the 4X Ultra Sharp and RESR game models provide enhanced detail in the images, particularly in terms of hand shapes, which appear quite pleasing. However, the SEO netsets also introduce more details, but unfortunately, they cause the hand shape to be distorted. If the image does not include a hand, or if we introduce a negative prompt to modify it, it may be worth trying. While SYIR takes a bit longer to generate the image, it adds more intricate details to it. On the other hand, LDSR takes the longest time to generate the image, but adds the most beautiful details. We can consider using LDSR as a middle stage image, and then apply to image-to-image function to enlarge a finer image. In conclusion, my preference for normal scaling methods would be use latent, ultra sharp, RESR gain, and swing IR. As for the final post-processing treatment, I recommend employ LDSR. If you enjoy my content, please consider subscribing to my channel. Thanks for watching.